Star. Star.
For the wind car.
Yeah.
Can't fly as... Oh, man.
We're gonna still see.
No,
we got some time.
Yeah. And honestly, he's done such a great job at now.
ECS, maybe?
In all fairness, he's gonna hit spirits only level 5. So, fly able to lock down the land. They are going to go for this play. Just look at the top. In this case, they're...
And now, get dunked.
Yep. That's what Cannon has to say. Spirit, you have flag and grass.
Oh, boy.
That's a sad moment for Spirit.
I've been there. They're going to do it themselves. Solid 659 smite. That's not good enough.
You got to get it lower.
Cannon has the patience to wait.
Cannon,
the younger player, the two junglers. I was just talking about how I really prefer the main support or the enchantress support get killed because once they complete their gold item, they don't typically keep accelerating that quickly. They come online that much faster, stacks on the Dark Seal.
Absolutely. I think there is an argument to be made to play it early.
Especially because there's already been a nice amount of action. Just the pacing of the game, more kills coming in. I don't want to cast sisters. I wave a slip of the dock here. The thing is, not accelerating at a pace that she would like. She still does have a little dive down here with a grit.
It's going to pick up the kill. Do it. Spirit is going to land. I was about to lose my mind. The UV was going to 1v3.
From the side of Afreeca getting one back. Ends up being a 2 for 1. But minion waves and turret plates with teleport. So, the Seekers are currently stuck in a Build-A-Bear workshop with the Seekers on guard, the Fairy Charm, the Vampiric Scepter, Crafting Potion. You don't know where Tail's going when Dorn doesn't have ward items to build, because they don't really have ward items either.
So, everything is so disjointed. I don't know what happened there. Did he try to suplex the Nautilus? Got beat called in the waves? I don't know. Oh, we missed. Looking for a second play of the game.
Makes up a couple. And they should be able to raise one more turret plate against this horn. Will depend on the Amulet did not just walk up. Warren doesn't have a ding. That may be Dark with the round, but offers spot for Cannon. Will he survive? Was it a big bait? All in the end, he's going to go down. Warren wants to run a really awkward spot here. This is his first down. But how do you face off against the Calista? As the last thing you do here is going to try to run. And that wasn't an ace. I mean, it doesn't say ace, but because one did end up respawning. But this game is so wonky right now.
Let's take a look at all the salt trans fire jelly and this random green dragon right here inside the crowd with no reason.
And Showmaker just air to pick them up and punish. This is so weird. Oh, actually did not see Spirit. So we thought this was where the hell did Spirit come from. Showmaker missed the combo on fly to get the the dawn, eventually brought down by flies. And then tries to destroy the prey. But not able to.
And you have to stay there and try to fight.
I mean, it doesn't happen too often in the LCK, but when you're going up against the Kalista, that is doing quite well. And, is kiting you down. You're not going to be able to do much, so, as you can see, they are going for a bit of a dive now on the bottom side, but trying to help out here is Jelly. Nice little knockout, but Mystic is going to go down, waiting for the Quinn. As they do lock it down. Here's Fly, Showmaker.
Not sure about that.
He went out of the guy, and Showmaker now zoned out a little bit. Tries to trade him back, offers spot to Showmaker, but he is able to knock him back. Neither ram.
So this is a really unique thing that a lot of people don't know about Yumi, but going inside of a teammate doesn't break turret aggro, because obviously that would be abusive.
So when you're still with your turret range, simply by entering your teammate, it's not break aggro until Yumi herself has exited. So a bit unfortunate. Maybe not even aware of that interaction. Probably aware of it, but maybe not in that exact moment.
There was so much going on that he just got dunked underneath the turret, unfortunately.
And now we do have the Drake up here. This has been a game that we don't really focus on the Drakes too much. Notice there's only one Drake that has come down. But Afreeca this time really wanting to pick this one up. Looks like Damwon really wants to collapse on this one, moving north, and Quinn is back, so this will just be the Drake. Take him down in a Cloud Soul coming up next. And at this point, Kale has hit level 11. Still on the Caesar's Guard, no boots either for her. And I do think that Fly is building Frozen Fist. So definitely a bit of a letdown. Not going to be the Sunfire Cape.
Yeah.
And let's take a look at this. Honestly, Sunfire starts off not very clean, and ends up blocking a lot of the Third Aggro, able to help out with that. And the pay attention to this. Her ultimate still going, and she ends up dying. Just like that. Tickle's one. Yeah, so make her out of the way. Careful about this, you're going to be locked down by the gunplay. They're actually draining it back. And will they hunt him down is the question. Not quite going to focus on that one. And the Kill Tor. Trying to burst down Mystic here. He's not sure why he's there by himself, but his target is Quinn, collapses this fast. As now, there's kind of a sad panda in this game. All by himself, he lost the support. It's like a solo game for support to leave you alone in a bad landing phase. I'm hoping they leave. And Cloud Soul, being the Drake of the game, is not super big.
Although on Hail and on Ward maybe it can do some stuff because you have to pack three of them, and if you end up packing on CR, that is pretty scary, flashing out, not getting enough damage, and flying, you're living.
Yeah.
Imagine not banning Ward. Just 2020.
I'm a true. I can tell you, this game, if you have 21 kills, we have 21 kills, they have always fighting. Okay, yeah.
It works.
It really does. Well, your oxygen is getting scarier by the minute. Approaching that level 16 mark, level 13 now. And nuclear cannot lane against Sky. Just for reference, if that lane continues the way it's going,
he's not going to have a good time.
Kale is reaching her end game. I'm really curious if Kale is going to go Nashor's 2. I think all things considered, given that there's some magic resistance on the side of Dom Juan's game right now, that maybe Trinity Force getting more upgrade would be better. Not entirely sure, really clear spots on Kale. Not everything is as plain as whether or not to go Borello. Yeah.
Which, in our opinion, is pretty plain most of the time.
Exactly. Okay, trying to go 1v1 here, Keith, as Ultimate Spirits nearby.
And the TP's coming in. They cannot get the damage. Nuclear is just not able to do anything in the backline, and everybody's rotating now.
That's going to be three kills over the side of Afreeca, nothing he can do. As Sentawani was complimenting over here.
This is really ugly.